misconceptions related to square roots of decimals. Friends, welcome to this video. In the previous video, we saw examples involving square root of decimal numbers. In this video, we will see a misconception related to the square root of decimal numbers. Four friends are trying to find out the square root of the number 0.0144. Their answers are as follows. Can you tell who has given the correct answer? You may pause the video here and solve the question yourself. We know that the square root of 144 is 12. Amit, while finding the square root of 0.0144, used 12 as the square root of 144 and thus added 0.0. This is a misconception. Vishal derived the square root of this number in this way. Here, the square root of this number is equal to a whole number. This means that Vishal's answer is incorrect. The answer of both Rahul and Vikas is the same, but their understanding is different. Now let's look at Rahul's answer. He thought that there is no value of 0 after the decimal, so he removed the 0. This gave him the number 0.144. The square root of the number 144 is 12. So, while finding the square root of this number, Rahul wrote the square root of 144 and then put a decimal before 12, which gave him 0.12 as the answer. This answer is correct, but the method of solving it is incorrect. Now let us see how Vikas has solved this question. This number has only the decimal part. So first of all, he made a pair from the right of the decimal point and placed bars on the numbers. Then he found the largest number whose square is equal to or smaller than the number below the leftmost bar. Here, that number is 1. Subsequently, considering the number obtained as the divisor and the number below the leftmost bar as the dividend, he found the remainder. The remainder obtained here is 0. Because the first divisional number was 1 in the decimal part, we would first add the decimal to the quotient and then the first digit would be 1. Solving in this way, the square root of this number is 0.12. Thus, Vikas's answer is correct. We can also find the square root of this number in this way. Here, we have used decimal numbers as rational numbers. By converting it, we have found its square root. Now let's find the sum of the square roots of these numbers. In order for you to solve this, you have been given hints. You can try to solve it together with your friends. In this video, we saw a misconception related to the square root of decimal numbers. See you in the next video. Thank you.